Broadcasting from the Secrette Bar in downtown Toronto, this is the LeDrew 3-Minute Interview. And my guest right now is Mitzie Hunter, legislator, member of Provincial Parliament for Ontario, for Scarborough-Guildwood, and former cabinet minister. You know something about racism. Very few people, if any, will agree that there's not racism in Ontario, in Canada. So there's a problem. Give us your answers on how to deal with that problem.
One of the things we have to do, Stephen, is we have to talk about it. And I think that that's what's happening right now. We have a change moment. We've been awoken to the issue. We need to talk about it. And then we need to figure out some policy changes that need to be made to correct the problem.
This is where I want to go. I'm glad you mentioned it because we need to figure out some policy changes. But you've always been black. And you've always been interested in these issues. You have felt racism, I'm sure. So tell the audience right now some of the policy changes that you want to bring about. You were a minister too.
Yeah. One of the things that I want people to do is when they're in a boardroom, a meeting room, look around the room. Who is present, but who is not present? And more often than not, you'll realize that black Canadians are not present. We're not at the decision-making table, which is one of the reasons why, you know, as a policymaker, I think about that. How do we change those economic outcomes for black people here in Canada? It starts with education, all the way from elementary, secondary, and into post-secondary education as well, which is why under the former Liberal government, we had things like free tuition to make post-secondary a possibility. When we looked at the numbers, Stephen, people on higher income who oftentimes are non-racialized automatically went to college and university. We had to correct that. It wasn't about achievement and ability, it was simply about the ability to pay.
So Mitzie, you're dealing now with the corporate world, and we hear that, and we all heard that answer. What about the day-to-day racism? There's education, it's a big deal, it's
a huge deal.
Do you have any other solutions?
Absolutely, big deal. Look at the occupation, right? So as a black woman, all things being equal, I earn 87.6 cents for every dollar a white woman would earn. Why is that? We have to correct that.
You earn the same as a legislator.
Pay transparency. Pay transparency is something that we need. It's actually going to benefit black people and other people of color, as well as women, making sure that there's transparency in the workplace in terms of salary and income.
Mitzie, do you
remove the biases?
Do you feel that you are prejudiced on both counts, the fact that you're a woman and the fact that you're black? It's a double whammy.
Listen, Stephen, there is no question. As a black woman, oftentimes I walk in a room as the minister, people are speaking to my aide because of the perception challenge that we have. We have to change that perception. Who are the leaders? Who are the politicians? Who are
the
teachers? Who is in front of the classroom?
I have 10 seconds left. How do we change the perception?
We make sure that people of color, black people, have equal opportunity like everyone else.
Mitzie Hunter, it's been a pleasure. I hope you come back.
Yes.
Thank you very much. And that's the 3 minutes. Thank you for watching. We have many more interviews like that in production. We are going to be having the interviews that you will not see on the mainstream media. If you like it, please subscribe to LeDrew 3-Minute Interview.